If living is seeing, I'm holding my breath. Written by Sunny Moraine. Read to you by Greer Morrison.
The third blackout of the week is sudden and expected. Riley thinks it's the third, but she long ago stopped trying to gauge time in terms of weeks and months and even years. So this is only an estimate and not one she especially cares about. She's resigned to the blackouts, and the patterns of her days render them no more than a minor inconvenience. Her grocery deliveries still happen with sufficient reliability. The spoilage of a few things now and then is also no big deal. At some point, she threw her cell phone into a creek and along with it an app that would have notified her if she was within 50 feet of another person, if they also had a phone, if they also had an app enabled. An act of socio-technical faith. She wasn't altogether certain why she threw the phone away. It had been a kind of fit, a moment she only vaguely remembered later as if she had been drunk, which she hadn't. She only remembers feeling in the whipping motion of her arm and the gleaming arc of the thing through the twilight, something terribly like a species of defiant, nihilistic despair. Anyway, when there's power, there's internet, and she can keep ordering. Strange, she muses as she steps down from the porch and starts to head down the long gravel drive. The things that continue when so many other things have ceased. The truth is that she stopped paying attention to those things that don't directly affect her. The truth is she's not certain what continues and what's ceased. These things continue for certain, if unevenly so. The power, the water, deliveries, trash collection, internet. She has not seen a single human face in longer than she can reckon. That last is special, because other people must be adhering to it if those things are still running. No faces, no eyes. Not if you want to survive. Riley does want to survive, although she can no longer recall why. Other things, visible. The stipple of the sunlight through leaves all along the gray gravel river of the drive. The dark pillars of the trunks. The little forms of squirrels darting through the underbrush and chasing each other with the birds between the branches. Riley loves these sights, with the same absent affection one feels for the ordinary. Back in the house, there are unsigned paintings on the wall, none of which contain human faces. Many bookshelves, some containing books with pictures, and again, no faces. After the first days of bloody chaos, it was determined that for the most part, still images, paintings and photos alike, of human eyes didn't induce the madness, but in a few cases they did, and no one was sure of what the images or the victims had in common. So it was safer to avoid the images altogether. Riley saw photos and paintings with the eyes erased or scratched out. Most people found those too disturbing, an inescapable reminder of the nightmarish new world, so they didn't look at all. Her books, lamps that gave off a gentle warm light, faded wallpaper, old furniture. Many things in the house are old. It was her grandparents.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.